Hey everyone, this is Jeremy from JME 3D Reviews, talking today, giving you hints how to turn any 2D image into a 3D image. For example, I drew a picture here, as you can see on the screenshot, just of a Pac-Man-like shape. What I'm going to do, take any image. I've done examples of this before, taking a contour gauge and using that to trace a shape that I need, such as like a door jamb or a plug. So we take this image, download it, I emailed it to myself, save it to the desktop, call it image one, and then we go to a website, and there's multiple ways of doing this. This is a website I use, it's free, it doesn't put anything on the image itself as like a watermark. Website name is svgcreator.com. SVG, look that up and let you know what that means. That is a scalable vector graphic. So this is a vector type image. It's easily accessible. You can do it on, I believe, Inkscape. You can do it on GIMP with a plugin. For my purposes, I just use a website. Usually I've got internet access so I can do this. It converts any image into an SVG, which is a more accessible image that we can upload to 3D printers, CNC machines, that type of thing. So we go here, click on select your picture, found image one. This takes a minute to convert it depending on which image you have. And we're going to fast forward here. While that's loading, we're going to open up Tinkercad. And we're going to sign in. While that's signing in, see if our image is done. There we go. You can see what I did here was took a white piece of paper, took a black Sharpie, and did a continuous line. You don't want any gaps in between the line. You want a solid, continuous line. So we do this, we download the image, save file. We'll change this to image one. That will save as image1.svg. Go back to Tinkercad, create a new design. And you can upload SVG, I believe, into Fusion 360. I'm just using Tinkercad because it's a simple, easy program for pretty much anybody new to the game or that's been at it a while to use. Go up in the upper right corner, click on Import, choose a file, and we're going to find the SVG, which is image 1. Upload that, and at this point, you can take a pair of calipers and you can measure what size you want this image. If you did a tracing on a piece of paper using a contour gauge or graph paper, I don't suggest using graph paper as it will pick up the graph as part of the SVG, so just plain white paper. Once this is traced on here, I'm not going to worry about changing the size, but the dimensions on Tinkercad are 1,000 by 1,000. That's a maximum size that it can take. So do take that into consideration when you're uploading it. And we'll fast forward again. Alright, as you can see, this is a little bit oversized. So I'm going to zoom out. And I want this image to be, we're going to call it 32 by 30. Close to that. 32 by, we'll do 32, we'll make it squared. So now that that's resized, we'll zoom back in. As you can see, I've got the image that I drew converted to SVG and uploaded to Tinkercad. Right now, this is three-dimensional. It's 30mm, 30mm by 10. If I wanted to make, say, a hollow vase with no bottom to it, so just a holder of some sort, we can go, let's say we want to add, we'll do 30 high. So now we've got this shape here. And as you can see, it picked up something in my drawing. I'm not sure what this little sketch mark is, but we can simply take a box, place it around the object. We're going to do the hole, make sure it's not intersecting the object that we want to keep. Make sure it's as tall as the object that we're trying to delete. It's 30, I'm just going to drag and drop it. Select both items, group. There we've effectively deleted that sketch mark. So now I can export this. I'll do the selected shape, STL, and then save file. Tinkercad automatically assigns a name. This is Bodacious Wolt. I'm going to change it to image 1. And I'll save it as a STL. Go into Kira. Here's a previous print that I had going, making a succulent pot for my wife. Clear build plate, open, and image 1, which is going to be the STL file. Open that up. There we have it. We've successfully turned a 2D drawn image into a 3D file by converting it first to an SVG file. If you guys like this material, feel free to give me a thumbs up, give me a like, hit that subscribe button or the bell, and hope you folks have a great rest of the evening. Thanks for watching.